What's up, guys? This is Clay. I am the owner and president of Thunder Laser USA. And today, I wanted to talk about the differences in brands of laser machines. So you might be shopping around for a laser machine and you're looking at different brands and you're thinking all these things look the same. There's all these statistics, there's all these specifications. How do I know which one's better or are they better? So today I want to dive into something that I refer to as build quality. So I'm going to talk about some of the different things between the machines that make Thunders the best. So the first thing I want to talk about today is ease of use. So our machines are an open concept. So if you look inside here, all these parts are easy to get to. So they're easy to maintain, they're easy to clean. And if you can also open the doors, you can get to all these different components over here. So this means if something ever goes wrong, you're able to easily access the components. Whereas some other machines, everything's either packed in there or you have to take off plates, or they're just very hard to get to the different components of the machine, which you need to access to be able to easily maintain and service the machines. The second thing I love about our laser machines is the materials and components that go into them. So our machines are almost exclusively made out of metal. You'll find a lot of laser machines out there made out of plastic. The quality of components, the motors, all of this allows the machine to be more repeatable. It's gonna lend you more to that production environment. You don't want a laser that's gonna wear down over time. So if it's made out of cheaper materials, if you think about it, you know, a laser machine is moving back and forth a whole bunch. So if your machine is not truly built to last, if it's made out of cheap components, you're gonna start to feel that over time. Our machines stand up over time. So the third thing I love about the build quality of these machines, guys, is the alignment. So if you look at a laser, the laser beam comes out over here, it goes around. So it's coming, the laser tube is out there, it comes out, and it's going around, it's making this little diagram here. And so if your machine shakes and it comes out of alignment, these mirrors get out of alignment, then you're having to stop production to align the mirrors. And our machines come to you out of the crate pre-aligned. So when you get your machine, you'll be able to open it up out of the crate. You don't have to do any alignment or anything like that. On top of that, a lot of other lasers come out of alignment pretty frequently. So if you're having to stop production to align your machine, align your mirrors, that's gonna slow you down. You're not gonna have as much production time. You're gonna be, if you're spending, you know, 2-3 hours aligning your machine once a week, what does that do to your production schedule? So be sure to think about that, guys. How often does a machine come out of alignment? It really speaks to the overall build quality of the machine. Our machines really don't come out of alignment unless you hit something with the head or something like that. So you're not going to be aligning these machines very often, if at all. So just keep that in mind as you're shopping around. All right, the fourth thing I love about our build quality is the quality of the wiring. So guys, this is super important. This is the brains of your laser machine. And as you can see, these are all very well laid out, well thought out. There's nothing, you know, random about this. And each one of these wires is clearly labeled. So if you are on the phone with support, they can easily say, hey, check to make sure wire M7 is tight and things of that nature. So if you see a laser machine that's not wired like this, it's definitely going to give you trouble as you start to support it. Your machine is inevitably going to need support. And when you open this up, you want this to be nice and clean. So this is a competitor machine, guys, and this is what poor wiring looks like. So if you're gonna have to support a machine that's wired like this, it's going to be very difficult. And the fifth thing I love about our machines, guys, is the quality control that goes into them. So these machines are rigorously tested before they're sent out. I would say one of the biggest things and one of the biggest quality control points that I wanna hit on is testing of the tubes. So actually all of our tubes have to test at 10% over the stated power. So if we're selling you an 80 watt tube, that means in our quality control, it actually had to output 88 watts. A lot of laser companies like to say it's an 80 watt tube, and really it's more like, you know, 70 or somewhere less than 80, but we always want to under promise and over deliver. That's one of the things that we want to do to make sure that we have the best built machine for you guys. So these are just a few of the things that I love about our build quality of our machines, but these are definitely things that you want to pay attention to as you're shopping for a laser machine. Build quality is likely the most important thing when you're purchasing a laser. So reach out to us if you have any questions, guys. Sales at Thunder Laser USA. We'd love to talk to you soon.